Okay, the gloves are off. This is a vegetable, and therefore not a fruit. Through and through. 100%. But wait, you may say. Botanically, tomatoes are a fruit, and therefore not a vegetable. Well, that is partially right. Botanically, tomatoes are a fruit, but that statement as a whole is a category error, a false dichotomy, and only half scientific. Did I just contradict myself there? Didn't I just say that this was not a fruit? Yes. Am I just claiming some hippy-dippy, wishy-washy, postmodern, pseudo-linguistic balderdash, as my friend accused me of? More or less, paraphrased. I would argue not. Allow me to explain. This whole debate has been raging at least since the 1800s, when the US government was trying to figure out whether to tariff tomatoes as a fruit or as a vegetable, and it flares up in the public scene every now and again. But the common conclusion hinges on a misunderstanding. One of the most important things to do in any debate from the start is to clarify terms, to say, when I use this word, what do I mean by it? After all, words can have different definitions in different contexts. That is uncontroversial. If you don't do that and you're using the same words to mean slightly different things, you can very easily end up talking past each other and end up missing where the disagreement actually lies. So, what is a fruit and what is a vegetable? The first snag, it depends. The argument people often make here is that tomatoes are a fruit because they fit the biological or botanical definition of fruit, which the Oxford Dictionary of Biology gives as the structure formed from the ovary of a flower, usually after the ovules have been fertilized. Okay, in simpler terms though, the ovary is the part of the flower where pollen gets transferred to during pollination, fertilizing the ovules, which turn into seeds within the fruit. So what this means for the average Joe is that, generally at least, a botanical fruit will be the part of a plant that contains one or more seeds, assuming it hasn't been bred to be seedless, though that would still fit the definition. So watermelon? Yeah, it's a fruit. Blueberry? Yep. Grapes? Yep. Tomatoes? Yeah, they develop from the ovaries and contain the seeds, so botanically, they're a fruit. And by the same definition, you can also include eggplants, zucchinis, cucumbers, peppers, acorns, and milkweed pods full of fluff. So, an open and shut case. Biologically, tomatoes are a fruit. Sure. But I won't agree that therefore they're not a vegetable. And why did I say earlier that they're not a fruit? Well, here we're at two more snags. When most people use the words fruit and vegetable, they're not using the scientific definitions of those words. They're using the culinary definitions, the ones more concerned with cooking and eating the thing. There, a fruit would generally be defined more like this. A plant part that is usually sweet or sour in a way that means they're more likely to be used in a sweet dish, like a dessert, or maybe eaten raw at breakfast. Things like bananas, cantaloupes, kiwis. By contrast, a vegetable, by these definitions, would be one that would be more suitable for using in a savory dish, before the main part of a meal. Things like celery, potatoes, cucumbers, eggplants, and peppers. And noteworthily, mushrooms sometimes get included with vegetables too, even though they're not plants. Now, you'll notice these definitions aren't particularly clear-cut or scientific. There's a lot of gray areas that could depend on how you or your culture use a particular plant part. Avocados, here in the West, we use them more in the vegetable way. In parts of Asia, not necessarily. I remember seeing chocolate avocado smoothies when I was in Indonesia, and when I expressed surprise to my friend there, she was just like, thought it strange. Was like, why is that strange? It's a fruit. And some odd exceptions. Starchier, sweet things like pumpkins are more likely to get lumped in with vegetables, despite being common in pumpkin pie. Some things could be a fruit or a vegetable, depending how ripe they are. Unripe papayas, for instance, get used to make salads in Southeast Asia. Some, like lemons and limes, walk a weird middle ground where they're considered fruits, but often used in savory dishes. So there may be fuzzy edges here and some subjectivity involved, and they're not totally mutually exclusive categories. But overall, most plant foods are easily classified into either one category or the other, ignoring for the moment other culinary categories like spice or grain. And thinking of tomatoes, a few creative exceptions aside, they would almost universally be labeled a vegetable and not a fruit here. Tomato sauces, curries, salads, all savory dishes. Unless you know of counterexamples, tomato-based desserts, for instance, but at least for most of the world, if you're using culinary definitions, the tomato is a vegetable and not a fruit. Now, you may say, sure, but scientifically, it's a fruit. And this often gets argued in a way that implies that because it's the scientific definition, it is therefore the more true definition. It's the one we should be using. It should take precedence over the culinary. And if the culinary definition was just a fuzzier, less precise version of the scientific definition, that would maybe be a good argument. The problem is, these two definitions are answering two completely different questions, and they're both really useful concepts to be able to say concisely. The botanical definition asks, how does this plant part function and develop within the plant? Whereas the culinary definition asks, how can I eat this thing? And you can't often use the answer from one question to answer the other. If my wife asked me to go out and get some fruit, and I came back with wheat, beans, tomatoes, cumin, loofah sponges, and cattail fluff, they're all fruits botanically, but it would understandably cause some discord in our relationship. I don't want to make her say, go and pick up some sweet or sour plant parts that wouldn't usually be used in a savory context. Being able to just say fruit is far more convenient. So, okay, this is useful, and then it makes sense why you can say this is a vegetable and therefore not a fruit. But why did I say earlier that it was wrong to say biologically this is a fruit and therefore not a vegetable? Why is that statement incoherent? Well, you may have noticed in those definitions earlier, I didn't give the biological definition of vegetable. So what is it? You'll sometimes see people say it's an edible plant part that is not botanically a fruit. Okay, that's pretty neat and tidy, and then it'd be pretty easy to say this is a fruit and therefore not a vegetable biologically. Hey presto, case closed. And that would all be well and good if that were an accepted biological definition. But it's not. In botany, the definition for vegetable would be, well, it's not in there. There isn't one. Botany, again, is looking at how things function within the plant and has no real reason to concern itself with how we eat it. Ethnobotany, sure, with the study of how people use plants. But there again, you're going to be using the culinary definitions. So what is the opposite category of fruit in a biological sense if it's not vegetable? Well, it's stem, leaf, root, flower, petiole, bract, tendril, any other plant part really, but not vegetable. So you can't compare this way saying the tomato is a fruit and therefore not a vegetable, because fruit, it's only a fruit if you mean the botanical definition, and then vegetable is not a mutually exclusive category. You can't say it's this and therefore not that if there's a bunch of overlap between those two categories. There's lots of botanical fruits that are vegetables. It's kind of like saying that cloves are biologically a flower bud and therefore not a spice. Spice is not a biological category, and there's nothing in its definition that says it can't be a flower bud. To take scientific words with technical definitions out of the picture for a moment, here's an analogy. Say my friend comes over for supper and I say to him, oh, you're late and now the food's cold. Do you want me to warm it up? And he says, cold? That's habanero pepper soup. Habaneros are hot. There's no way that could be cold. Now, assuming this isn't just a low-quality dad joke, this is basically the same issue. Hot has two definitions here. High temperature, and the opposite being cold, or hot, spicy, and the opposite would be mild, or not cold anyway. Two different meanings for hot, and you can't compare across those meanings as if they're exactly the same word. That's a category error. They're not the same. You can have a hot baked potato that isn't hot as in spicy, and you can have a cold frozen ghost pepper that is still hot in the spicy sense. So you cannot say, this is hot and therefore not cold, if by hot you mean spicy. That doesn't logically follow. It only sounds like it does because we're conflating the two meanings of the word hot, just like our two meanings of the word fruit. Now, I can imagine one final counterargument from people who read older books, who might say, well, natural scientists of the past used the word vegetable in a non-culinary way. Okay, if we're using archaic definitions, then sure, I'll grant, vegetable would have a scientific definition. But it just means plants in general. Oak trees, pineapples, baobabs, moss, also even mushrooms if you go back a little ways before they realized they weren't plants. They'll often use it in the phrase the vegetable kingdom, meaning the plant kingdom. So that definition doesn't work for this argument either. By that definition, all fruits are vegetables. All plants are vegetables. Like, some used it to mean all edible plants, granted, but even then, by that definition, tomatoes would scientifically be a vegetable. If you disagree, by all means, please show me where I'm wrong, but I see no instance where the statement, the tomato is a fruit and therefore not a vegetable, can be true. And this whole discussion, fruits versus vegetables, it's kind of popular with the public, but there are a lot of other botanical terms this can happen with, and I'm sure this happens in other fields as well. Little mistakes that are easy to make because they relate to technical, highly specialized words that unfortunately happen to sound exactly like non-specialized words that most people use every day. It's very easy to overlook the distinctions and conflate the two. And you can find all kinds of sources getting this point wrong, even much more reputable sources when it's not part of their field of specialty, this and related mistakes. You'll sometimes hear the one about bananas being technically a berry, or I saw recently a Veritasium video where he mentioned how he had a hard time accepting eggplants as a berry and not a vegetable. Great video otherwise, and it was just a small side point he was making, but he attributed it to a particular psychological phenomenon, when really, again, it's just a matter of definitions. Berry, like fruit, has two completely separate definitions, botanical and culinary. The two overlap, but they are very different. In botany, yes, bananas and eggplants are berries, but in culinary terms, they are not. So a person is perfectly correct to say those things aren't berries because they don't fit the definition that most people are using all the time and have grown up deeply ingrained with. And there are also plenty of botanical berries that are culinary vegetables. And there's a bunch of other botanical words like this too. Nuts, as a botanical category, would not include almonds, coconuts, pine nuts, peanuts, or cashews. Herb, botanically, just means a seed-bearing plant that doesn't produce woody tissue, so that includes potato plants, pumpkin vines, and banana trees, which botanically aren't trees. And most root vegetables aren't botanically roots, instead being things like tubers, corms, and rhizomes. And yet, the culinary definitions of these are all handy words to have on hand. Even as a plant nerd, I'll admit, in everyday life, the culinary definitions are much more useful than the biological definitions. So why would we get rid of them? So, the long and short of it is, the tomato, is it a vegetable? Darn tootin' it is, incontrovertibly. Is it a fruit? Yes, if you mean the botanical sense, no otherwise. So, can you say it's a vegetable and therefore not a fruit? Yeah, that checks out. Can you say it's a fruit and therefore not a vegetable? No, that doesn't work here. It's a false dichotomy. No matter how you slice it, a tomato is still a vegetable. That U.S. tax law case I mentioned at the start concluded similarly, saying that, yeah, in botanical terms, tomatoes were a fruit, but that had no bearing on whether they were a fruit or vegetable in ordinary terms. Now, would it be great if we had two different sounding words for the two definitions of fruit, or berry, or nut? Yeah, maybe. Less confusion, I guess. Maybe we could use the Latin terms for the biological words. I don't know. But for now, fruit is the word we have for both. Anyway, I hope this was helpful. It can be confusing when you have this weird overlap between common words and technical jargon. I've been asked this question a lot, so thought it'd be good to fully explain myself here. If you have other examples of this, or maybe other terms you want clarified, let me know in the comments. As always, liking, commenting, and subscribing all really help me out. And if you'd like to support me further, you can find me on Patreon or YouTube memberships. And for more facts about plants, weird and wonderful, mundane and strange, I'll see you in the next one on Ambling with Sam.